Homo habilis appeared and lived in South and East Africa, a region that is considered the cradle of humanity, because this is where multiple species of Australopithecus and Homo appeared. Until the 1980s, Homo habilis was considered human because of his use of stone tools. But as I said before, this delineation is now contested, and some experts would put the species into Australopithecus. It is still fine to call them archaic humans in any case, because they certainly exhibit characteristics in which we can recognize signs of humanity. They used tools mainly for butchering, and it is believed that they form societies of a few dozen individuals. Much has been speculated about the organization of their societies, the distribution of roles between males and females. But the truth is that there is not enough evidence to conclude. What we know better is their appearance. They were relatively small, around 3 to 5 feet depending on individuals. Males were taller. They were also relatively frail compared with us. They would have weighed 45 to 80 pounds, that's 20 to 36 kilograms. They consumed meat, which probably made a big part of their diet. And it is believed that a large part of this meat came from scavenging rather than hunting. They also ate fruit. We know it because the measured dental erosion on specimens is consistent with regular exposure to acidity. They could have spent time in trees. This is deducted from their proportions. They had long arms relatively to the size of their body, and hand bones that could have permitted precision gripping.